BC had a year of wild weather in 2021, with extreme heat in the summer and extreme rains in the fall, leading to multiple deaths and millions of dollars worth of damage. The so-called heat dome hit the province in late June, driving temperatures to record-breaking highs for several days in a row, until Lytton became the hottest place ever seen in Canada, hitting 49.6 degrees Celsius on June 29th. The very next day, the town burned to the ground, killing two residents. But even without the addition of wildfires, the BC Coroner Service later determined 595 British Columbians died due to the extreme heat this summer. June's spiking temperatures was the start of a particularly devastating wildfire season in BC's southern interior, with scorching hot temperatures and drought conditions contributing to the fast-growing destructive wildfires. Hundreds of homes were destroyed throughout the summer. But as the wildfire season slowed down into the cooler fall months and communities began to rebuild, a series of atmospheric rivers soon hit BC in mid-November, causing widespread flooding and landslides across southern BC. This forced thousands to evacuate in Abbotsford, Merritt, Princeton, and Tullamine, among other places. All highways connecting the interior and lower mainland were cut off by landslides, causing some supply chain issues, and five people were killed in a slide north of Pemberton. And now, as British Columbians look to rebuild in the wake of multiple extreme weather events, the frequency and severity of these events are expected to increase in the coming years.
Without question, this has been a very active streak since mid-September on the heels of an extremely wet, dry and hot summer. So we have gone from some extremes to other extremes. And unfortunately, this is consistent with what climate change has been projecting for all parts of Canada, including the mid-latitudes here in BC. The frequency, the amplitude of these events, and their longevity individually will continue to increase with the coming years and decades.
For Castanet News, looking back on 2021, I'm Nick Johansson.